Hello guys, it's Eglow here. You're welcome to my YouTube channel. You're welcome to this tutorial. All right, so in this video, right, I'll be taking you through my high-end retouching tutorial. You understand? So especially if you're a beginner, I'm going to take my time to break every step, like every step of the editing. I'm going to take my time to break it down in a more simplified manner. You understand? So stick to the channel and go nowhere. All right, so I've color graded the picture. Let me show you the before. You want me to do video on how I color graded this picture? Let me know in the comment section so that I can do that as soon as possible. All right, so just like I said, in this video I'll be taking you through my high-end retouching, especially for beginners photo editing. And let me say this, right, don't just watch what I do, you understand, also listen to what I say, right? Because it is the, you know, the combination of the theory and the practical that will make it to stand out, that will make, that will help you to, you know, have a better and a clinical editing, you understand? So make sure you listen very well. I am going to take my time to explain this thing in detail. Do you understand? All right, so let's make these layers. Good. So if you look at this picture now, if you look at this picture now, to some extent, I still have my details. You can see the picture. I still have my details, right? And it's also a close shot. I'm going to take my time to explain to you why you need to choose a certain radius number and why you shouldn't choose a certain radius number. So stick to this video, just like I said. Thank you. I'm just going to create my action, right? So let's just go straight to it. Workspace, come to, okay, photography. All right, good, we are here now. So come to action, then high frequency, you know, choose 16 bits, then action. Yes, so this is where it is getting interesting. Now if you look at this radius now, the default number, default digit now is 14, right? So I'm not going to use that 14. I just want to take my time to explain something here for you. Let me drag it down to zero so that you can see very well. All right, so if you look at this picture now, right, it's a close shot. Ideally, when I'm editing close shot, I usually use higher numbers like 5, 6, 7, 8. Most times I can even use 10. Do you understand? Now let me explain to you what radius, or in choosing radius, what you need to consider and why, and what radius does. Do you understand? What radius does to your skin tone tells in the softness of the skin or the hardness of the skin. Okay, let me take that again. The number of radius you choose will determine the level of the softness of the skin or the level of the hardness of the skin. What do I mean? Take for instance now, if I choose, let's say I choose 8 now, and I go with this radius number to edit this picture, the skin is going to be very hard. I don't know if I get, not that the editing is not going to make sense. Of course, it will make sense. You see that, okay, this is a good editing, but the skin is not going to look soft, right? So if I come down and choose, let's say 2, 1 point or 3, the skin is going to look soft. Do you understand? So I've watched countless of videos. In fact, I've not seen someone who has been able to explain this in detail as I'm doing now. So this is like a secret. You understand? So this is like a cheat code to editing. So take your time and listen to this thing that I'm saying. So it's not about, you know, just start editing, retouching. No, this is very necessary. I take my time to break down all these things, right? Before you choose your radius, make sure you know what you want to achieve for that particular picture. Don't just choose radius because you see people choosing higher number for close shot, or you see people choosing a lower number for, you know, a wider shot. You just choose to, I've seen people using 3, I've seen people using 6. You just choose to know, it is not like that. So you need to know why, so that, you know, at your own convenience, you can always choose a number that will give you the best result. I did a video before. I'll drop the link of that video in the comment section, or in the description rather, where I talked about my retouching process, right? It's also a close shot, but I use a higher number in that editing, and the skin was very hard, but I still had a very clinical retouching, right? So I'm going to do a reverser in this video. So I'm going to use a lower number now because I want to have a very soft skin. So that is it. The lower the number, the softer the skin. The higher the number, the harder the skin. You see how your textures. I want to use 3 for this particular picture, 3.0. All right, we are good. This is it. Okay, so let's pick our mixer brush. So for the set, come here and choose soft round. So when you choose soft round, right, so you come here and let it be on custom. Make sure it is on custom. You can see this. Make sure you check this and uncheck this. If you meet these two, check. So this first one, make sure you uncheck it and leave this one like that. Good. So now let's come to the brush settings. Look at the digit. Now let me also explain something here. That the first video I did about retouching, right, my settings from wet, load, mix and flow, right? I use 22 as my, you know, settings to edit that picture. But in this video, right, I'm going to use a different settings to edit this picture, and I'll still have a nice editing. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is that I used to say that when you watch people do something, right, it is better to understand it or understand them than to copy them. You understand? Because when you copy people, in a way, you are limited. But when you understand it, at your own convenience, you can be, you know, right? So you can play around things. So please take notes. These are hidden tricks about editing, about retouching, that you find it difficult to see or to hear about anywhere. So that's why I'm taking my time to break down all these processes, so that at the end of everything, right, you look and say, oh, this man is doing magic. Oh, I'm not even getting anything. So don't just watch what I do. Also listen to what I say. And at the end, make sure you understand it, not just copy. You just understand what I'm explaining, so that at your convenience, you can also, you know, choose what works for you. It is what works for you that matters. You understand? So what I'm telling you, what I'm teaching you, what you're watching in this video is just a foundation, big, just like a roadmap that will guide you on how to go about this. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you're just joining the channel for the very first time, don't forget to like this video, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Also turn on the notification button, so that you know you can be notified at any time we drop valuable content on this channel. Thank you. So let's get into it, right? Low frequency and high frequency. Okay, let me explain this, right? The low frequency is for skin, it's for skin tone, the skin smoothening, the skin retouching. While the high frequency is for spot, it's for blemishes, to remove blemishes, to remove spot, right? So take note, please. Then, okay, let me also say this, right? You watch some videos where some people, before they start retouching, they will have to pick the blemishes, you know, pick the spot, the pimples, and all of that, right? But in my own case, most times I don't usually do that. I'm not saying it is bad, right? You can do that. So my concern is always go for what works for you. At the end of everything, the goal is to achieve a better result. You understand? So I'm going to retouch first. I'm going to retouch the skin first before I pick the blemishes. All right, let's get into it. And don't forget that the skin tone is divided into three segments. We have the highlight, we have the mid tone, and we have the shadow. The highlight is where the light falls majorly, like the brightest part of the skin is the highlight. The darkest part of the skin is the shadow. The space in between the highlight and the shadow is the mid tone. Please take note. If you look at this picture now, this is highlight. You can look at this nose. You can look at here. Look at here. Also look at the lips here. These are highlights. These are highlight. But if you look at this place now, this is shadow. This is shadow. This is shadow, right? But if you look at this place now, you can't say this is shadow. You can't say this is highlight. So it's going to be your mid tone. All right. Enough of the talk. Let's get into it. Good. My mixer brush settings now. My wet is start one. I'll leave my load on 30. Then my mix on 30. Then flow 25. You understand? So, all right. Let's get into it. I want to have a very soft skin tone for this model, right? So please, if you are retouching, please don't drag, right? So don't drag, whether you are using Wacom pen or you are using mouse. So always make sure that you retouch every part separately. Retouch the mid tone separately, retouch the highlight separately, and also retouch the shadow separately. Then when you are done, you can now, you know, blend everything together, because what makes you a good researcher is your ability to blend the highlight, mid-tone, shadow together. That's what will make you to stand out as a good, and trust me, that is what retouching is all about. It is the blending of highlight, shadow, and mixing together that is called a retouching. All right, don't skip, make sure you watch this video to the end and watch what I'm doing, right? You can see. So be flexible with your Wacom pen, if you're using pen or you're using mouse, and maintain every part of the skin without dragging A to B or B to C. It's very important. You can see. So let's go to preview and let me show you where we are before after. You can see. So you see some people, when they are editing, they will love to zoom their pictures to as close as 200, 150, right? But if you look at me now, my own is 85 point, you know, 18%, you understand. So some people go for 100, just do what works for you, right? Just discover what works for you and stick to it. The goal is to get the best and the and great results. So it's not about copying Mr. A, copying Mr. B, and at the end of everything, you don't even know where you stand, and you don't even know what works for you. So it's very bad. Let me know in the comment section if you're also a retoucher and how you used to go about your retouching, right? Retouching or editing generally is an act of improving the quality of the picture, right? The quality of the image. If you are to edit a picture, what that simply means is that you have to improve the quality of the picture. Do you understand? So that is why you need to take your time and do a clean job. You can see that now we are able to, you know, blend the highlight, the shadow, and the mixing together without having to drag, you know, highlight to shadow to mixing. That is what retouching is all about. You can see that the picture is looking pink already. Hey God, trust me, editing is sweet, retouching is sweet, honestly. Let me show you a before and after. Let me zoom it a little bit. This is before after. All right, so let's go ahead and pick the blemishes. So my favorite tool in picking the blemishes is clone stamper. Some people use healing brush too. Yeah, sometimes I use it, but my favorite is clone stamp. So pick your clone stamp, then from the settings, make sure that the hardness is on higher figure. Don't let it not be soft. Make sure you bring it up to like usually use a higher this thing, right? Like 70. So this is fine. Yeah, hold your alt from the keyboard, pick here, then pick it, pick here, pick it, pick here, pick it, pick here, pick it. So continue the process till you are done picking the blemishes, right? Like I said, if you're a beginner in retouching and if you find it difficult to go about this retouching, trust me, as far as you are stick to this channel, I got you covered. And subsequently, I'll be dropping videos on my retouching process, you know, photo editing, skin retouching process like this to guide you through. And you can also let me know in the comment section which area do you want me to touch as far as photo editing, as far as photography generally is concerned, right? I got you covered. So feel free to comment whatever you want me to do, especially in my next video. And trust me, I'm going to take that into consideration. Don't rush, just take your time, right? Take your time and do clean job. Guys, if you watch this video to this very moment, I appreciate you as well. Please don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. All right, guys, so we are done picking the obvious blemishes, those distracting blemishes, right? Okay, let me show you before and after. This is before, this is after, this is before, this is after. So that's not all. So now I'm still going to pick my mixer brush and still, you know, brush through the sprite, because if you look at some of those, the areas that we pick some, that we pick those blemishes from, some are perfect, some are not perfect. If you look at this part now, so I'm going to use my mixer brush to just blend through, to just brush through and blend everything together. So just brush through, just blend everything together, and we'll be done with everything, right? Okay, we'll just whiten the eyes, then do some dodge and burn to make sure that the picture, to make sure that we pop the skin tone more. All right, guys, I think for now we are done with the skin retouching, so we can go ahead with the other things that we need to do. This is before, this is after, before, after. So let's go ahead and whiten the eyes. So come to adjustment, pick black and white, then from the red and yellow, drag the red and yellow to the very extreme end, then hide it, command I from the keyboard, hide it, then pick your brush, not mixer brush now, pick your brush, and this is, let's say, 30. So then that's opacity, then flow. I think the same thing as well. All right, so foreground white and start and start brushing through the eyes. All right, so okay, you can see this is before, this is after. If you feel that it is too much, you can reduce it before, after. So I love to keep it natural. I love to keep everything natural. So I'll just reduce it, let's say 60. Yeah, this is before now, after, just minimal, right? Good. So the next thing now is to, you know, let's just play with dodge and burn, right? No adjustment. Pick a curve. Curve. Then for the dodge, take it up a little bit. Come to blend mode option and select screen. Command I from the keyboard to hide it. That's for the dodge. Then go to adjustment again. Same curve. For the burn, bring it down a little bit, right? Go to blend mode option, click multiply, then command I to hide it from the keyboard. Good. If you like, you can name it. If you like, you can just leave it like this. So there's no time, right? So we are going to use our brush to speak already. That's what we use to whiten the eyes. But this time around, we are not going to use this digit that we use. We're going to go as low as, let's say 15 or 19. Okay, let me use 15, right? 15 opacity, then flow 15 as well. All right, so let's just zoom out a little bit and start. The dodge is for the highlight, while the burn is for the shadow. So your foreground, let it be on white. Make sure it is on white. Good, take note. So start brushing through the highlight of the skin. All right, I think we are done with the burn now. With the dodge now. So let's go to burn. That's for the shadow. You can see what I'm doing. Just take your time and watch it step by step, right? And trust me, you're going to have crispy image. All right, so I think I'm done with both dodge and burn. I'm going to group the two, select both layers. Command G from the keyboard to group them. Now let's see the before and after. This is before, this is after, this is before, this is after. So if you feel it is too much, you can reduce it, which I'm going to do now. So I'm going to reduce it, then come to opacity and reduce it. Let me reduce it to like 50. This is before, after, before, after. This is fine for me. So let's just go to the color now. All right, come to adjustment layer, click color balance. Yeah, it's on mix tune already. So mix tune, we can just add 3. Then for the yellow, let's say negative 3 as well. This is fine. Nothing serious. Before, after, before, after. Now I want to add level adjustment to pop the picture more, right? So I'll just add, let's say 4 here. I'll just add 4 here. Okay, here. Just come here, let's say 240. Yeah, 240. I think this is fine. This is before, this is after. You know, it makes the picture more pop, right? And guys, you can see. So let me show you where we moved from. We moved all the way from here. We moved all the way from here to here. We moved all the way from there to here. Guys, this is crazy. Let me zoom in so that you can see the skin tone very well. Can see that the skin tone is skin tuning. All right guys, so let's save. Okay guys, so this is a high-end screen retouching in Photoshop. So guys, we've come to the end of the video. You can see. So if you're just coming into the channel for the very first time, please, and you find value in this content, do well to give this video a thumbs up, comment, likes, turn on the notification button so that you don't miss out any of the invaluable content I'll be dishing out on this channel every week. If you're a returning subscriber, I appreciate you. Thanks for your support. Thanks for the encouragement. Please do well to comment, give the video a thumbs up, and share with others so that they can also benefit from. And let me know in the comment section what you want me to talk about, either about editing, lightning, color grading, or whatsoever that you want me to do or you want me to talk about in my next video. See you in my next video. Thank you.